Chapters are always broken down into three distinctive parts. You have the equal sign. This tells Excel that you are trying to perform a command. In this case, it's a formula. After the equals comes the actual command. Because it's a formula, we need to put sum. The formula command should typically be in uppercase, though Excel will correct this automatically when detected. The final part is the brackets. This is where information about the formula is stored. Some formulas have more than one input variable you can use. Where this is the case, each input is separated by a comma. Some only needs one input, the range of cell, or even the individual cell, that you want to sum up, so no comma is necessary. But you can use multiple individual cells or ranges if desired, which are also separated by commas. This will make more sense in a moment if it doesn't already. The sum formula is perhaps one of the simplest to get used to. The formula itself is designed so that it sums up all numbers that are contained within the defined range. The starting file that we're going to be using is the score_donations.xlsx. Okay, so this is the document that we're going to be having a look at. Within it, there are two tabs. You have the score and donations, and you have the sum ranges. So the score and donations tab is fairly straightforward. It's just designed to mimic a score and donation, hence the name. So each person's in a team. They were given a score in a game or whatever. They have the name, the region, and they have a donation that they submitted for whatever reason. So somebody's come to you. They want you to calculate all these donations. What's the final figure? Well, for that, you just simply use a ranged sum. So I have a little grey box in the corner here. Now, this is where we're going to be sticking our formula. The actual position of the formula itself doesn't really matter within Excel, but wherever you stick a formula is where the result tends to be. So let's just click on G3 because that's where we want to put it. And then just double click it to enter the cell or press F2. And we're going to start by typing in equals because that tells Excel that it's a command. So we also need to tell Excel what the command is. Well, in this case, we're going to be using the sum formula. So type in sum. Always open up a bracket. Now, as you can see, you get an option here, number one, comma, number two. What it's basically saying to you here is if you want to add multiple numbers, so what you could do is if you put in here B2, comma, B3, comma, B4, and then close the brackets, it'll basically add the three numbers that you've just added in. So B2, B3, and B4, and that equals 226. But if you scroll down, you'll see there's actually 1,000 records. It actually goes up to 1001 specifically, as you can see here. So that's the final number there, B1001. So you'd be here all day typing all those numbers in individually. So what you'd have to do, press F2 to enter the cell again and just delete everything after the bracket. Leave B2 there and then do a colon. We want to basically highlight the final cell in the range. So in this case, it's B1001, like that, simple as. And then if you close the bracket and then press enter, you'll see that the final number is £127,250.33, which obviously sounds a lot more like it than the £300 that it was a second ago. So that's great. So we know that works correctly. So let's have a look at the sum ranges tab. Okay, so within here, I've basically just randomly generated 30 names again, okay? Again, there's a payment and expenditure in this one. So you see that we've got like a blue total section, you have a green expenditure, and you have a yellow income. So the idea with this is just to mimic the fact that there is income, which is in yellow, and then you have like expenses or expenditure, which is in green. So we need to sum up what the income is and what the expenditure is, and what the total is after the expenditure. I'm also going to go over a few different methods at your disposal with this as well. So the first one then, let's just keep this simple. We want to simply add up the range of income, and then we want to add up the range of expenditure, and then take it away to create the total. Simple as that. So in method one, in the cell F4, we need to simply add up all the income. Yeah. So if you type in equals, and then if you type in sum, open bracket. And what you can do, if you're so inclined, is you can click and drag the relevant cells. So I'm going to start with C2 here and then drag down to C25, like that. If you let go, you'll see that Excel automatically adds the relevant cells into the formula. So if you close the bracket now, then press enter, you should find you get a result. So in this case, it's £120,609.86. So we're going to be doing the same thing with the expenditure. So if you do equals sum, open bracket, again, click and drag the cells in question, and then close bracket, you should get a final figure of £30,303.17. Now, a common way to deal with this now is to actually just take away the expenditure from the income directly here. A sum formula is as good as any to do that with. So if you type in equals, then type in sum, and then do F4, take away this time, F5. So, and then close brackets. So what you're basically doing now is you've got the cell F4, and then it'll take away F5 to get your final figure of F6, which in this case is 90,306. You do have the option of using multiple sum formulas, which is what I'm going to show you now. You can reduce the need for three cells down to just the one. So you notice you've got the income, the expenditure, and the total. There's three cells, you don't need all three of them. You don't need to see the income, you don't need to see the expenditure, all you need to see is the total, okay? This is for an example. So what you can do is actually just use multiple sum formulas. So in method two here, what you can do is if you do equals sum, open bracket. Again, if you used to just click and drag the relevant cells or type them in, depending on which one you prefer, and then close bracket. What you need to do now, if you want to basically start another formula, you don't need the equal sign, but you do need to say what you want to have happen to that formula. So in this case, we want to take away the expenditure. So minus sum, open bracket, and then click and drag the relevant cells here, and then close brackets like that. So if you were to press enter now, you should find you get the exact same result of £90,306.69. Down here in C32, I'm going to show you one other method again. Instead of typing in the cell directly, you do have the option of typing formulas and even just data into cells up here in the formula bar. So click on that. It's basically the exact same thing. So again, if you do equals sum and then open bracket, but I also want to show you another little thing. Remember in the beginning where I said you have the option of a comma? Well, what you can do is if you put in here C2:C25, and then put a comma, that's basically saying to Excel you've finished with that little bit of information. You want to go to number two in this case. So you want to take out the expenditure, yeah? So what you'd have to do is you'd have to put a minus sign first, because you're basically saying to Excel now that you want to take away the next bit of information. So in this case, C26:C31. Then if you close the bracket, then press enter, again, you should get the exact same information or the exact same answer, which in this case is 90,306, etc. Finally, for method three, if we just click on the cell here, in this case it was H6, I want to show you one last little tool you get. This button here next to the formula bar, the little FX, it says insert function. If you click on that, you get a little pop-up box. Basically, within this, you can actually say to Excel, you want to insert a formula. Now, you can see here, insert a function, sum is already there, but if you can't find it, you'd have to type in the formula itself first. So just put sum like that, and then click on go. And it'll give you all the formulas that are closely related to what you've typed into that field. In this case, we want the sum formula, so double-click on sum to load up this box. So the way this works now is you have number one, number two, number three. Essentially, these are the numbers between the commas, if you will. So in other words, let's just put the two ranges in here again, shall we? So we'll just remove the G6 there, because that's wrong. And then just click and drag, because you can do that with this as well. Like that. And then again, if you used to click on number two, you'll notice that number three pops up automatically. So that's one way where you can tell Excel that you want to add another number. But you want to take away the expenditure. So add a minus sign, and then highlights all the cells here. And it'll actually give you the results as well. So in this case, it's 90,306 there. So you know it's working correctly. So just as a point of note, you can actually see the formula being constructed in the formula bar at the top here. So the C2 to C25 is referring to this number one field, and this minus C26 to C31 is referring to the number two field. And you can keep this going with number three, number four, number five, etc. So I'm going to click on OK for this, and again it should just read the exact same number as the other ones have. I think that pretty much covers the basics of the sum formula. You can't really go wrong, you do get various different options with it. So I'm going to save this as score donations sum. Okay, that pretty much sums it up for the sum formula. Like I said, there's not much more I can say about it. It's fairly straightforward in a way. What I would recommend doing, if you're still not sure at this point, is just taking a fresh Excel document and put some numbers in it. So say A1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then in A6, try and use a sum formula. In the next lecture, we're going to be having a look at the count formula. Should be a fairly straightforward and easy video, so I look forward to taking you through it.